Assalamu alaikum and welcome back to Technology Explored. My name is Usman Chaudhry and in this video I'm going to perform SolidWorks simulation by using gravity as a load. So keep watching this video till end, and if you want to download these files for your practice, I will leave the download link in the description of this video. Let's start. First of all, I have, as you can see, I have opened this assembly. And now I have to start the simulation. So for that, first of all, I have to turn on the add info SolidWorks simulation. For that, click on this arrow next to the setting button and then from here select add-ins, and then check this box SolidWorks simulation and press OK button. So here you can see the simulation tab has been appeared, and then now we have to start a new study. So for that, click on this arrow and from here select new study. Name the analysis, so static one, and then simply press OK button. First of all, we have to define the material of our parts, and for that drop down this option parts, and these are three parts, A, B and C. So if you have same material for all these parts, just right click on the part and then select apply material to all. Or you have different materials, then you can select one by one and apply the material. So for example, the part A, I want to apply the material copper. So right click and then select apply or edit material, and then from this list select the material copper alloys, and then select copper, apply and then close. Similarly for part B, right click on it and then select apply or added material, and this time select alloy steel AISI 304, apply and then close. And for this part C, we are going to apply brass. So right click and then apply or added material, and then select from the list, and from here select brass, apply and then close. So we have applied the materials to our parts. Now we have to establish the connections between the parts. So for example, here you can see a bolt will be used as a connection, and for these two holes similarly a bolt. So for that, right click on the connection option here and then select bolt. These are the type of bolts, so I'm going to use this counter bolt screw. In the green box, it will ask you to select the cylindrical or circular edge for the bolt head. So select this edge, and in this box it will ask you to select a cylindrical face for thread hole. So select this hole and then press OK button. You can see a bolt has been appeared here. Similarly for these two holes, again right click on the connections and then select bolt, type of bolt, counter bolt, and then circular edge, this one, and cylindrical face, this one, and press OK button. And then for this one, right click again on connections and then select bolt, select type of bolt and this circular edge, and then thread hole, press OK button. So now we have to tell the SolidWorks what is our fixed geometry or what is our fixed part. So I'm going to fix this part from this side. For that, right click on the fixture and select fixed geometry. So this is our fixed geometry, and then press OK button. Now next thing is that we have to tell the SolidWorks what is our load. So basically I am going to apply the gravity on this part in this direction, in the Z direction. So for that, right click on the external load and from here select gravity. And here you can see this is the direction of the gravity, but we want the direction of the gravity on this side. So for that, selected reference, right click on this top plane and then select this face. Here you can see the gravity is on this direction. So now if you want to reverse the direction, uncheck this box to reverse the direction of the gravity, and now press OK button. We have applied the material, we have established the connections between the parts, and we have also fixed our geometry, and we have applied the load. Now it's time to create mesh. So for that, right click on the mesh here and from here select create mesh. One thing is to be remembered in creating mesh, your simulation results depend upon the quality of mesh density. So when you have fine mesh density, you have more accurate simulation results. So you have to take care of mesh density. To control quality of mesh density, you have two options. One is to drag this seek pair like this, or you can also check this box to put the values of mesh density manually here. So now press OK button to create mesh. It will take a while to create mesh. So here you can see the mesh has been created. So now we have to run the study. For that, click on this button, run this study. So here you can see the results of our simulation study: stress, displacement and strain. You can animate also your results. So for that, right click on the result and then select animate. Here is the speed of the animation. Now next thing is that how do we know if this part is okay to manufacture or not, or will it bear the load of this part or not. So for that, we have to right click on the results option here and then click on this option, define factor of safety plot, and then press OK button. So here, if you can see, factor of safety distribution 2.3, it means that this part is okay. The value of FOS or factor of safety determines whether your part is okay to manufacture or not. So if the value of factor of safety is below 1, which indicates your part is not okay to manufacture, so it should be or it must be above 1. So this was the way how to perform the SolidWorks simulation by using gravity as a load, and I hope you have learned from this video. Thanks for watching and sparing time.